Hello friends, welcome back to the video. In this session, we're going to talk about what is the use of add qualifier at primary. Last video session, we explored about add auto fire, add auto wired, add service, add component, right? Now we're going to see about this annotation. I will going to use the same example to use this annotation here, okay? Okay, what is this? Okay, here the customer service having one method called display name, also employee service having one method called display by name, customer service also having a method called display by name. Both are same name, okay, but it's doing a different job. That is display by name coming from customer service, which is gives the customer data. Display by name coming from employee service, which gives them employee data. Now I want to change this project design slightly. I want to follow some object oriented style. So I want to change the project design slightly. Okay, for that I'm going to create one interface. Make it as a base service. I'm making as a base service. Okay, this is the interface. Now I'm going to give this method declaration here. Method declaration here. Then I want to implement this method in both customer service as and employee service. For that I need to implement this method interface in the both the service class. Implements base service and employee service also implements base service. Sorry. Implement base service. So I need to override this. Override. Add to override. Add to override. And then customer service. Where is the employee service? Okay, now customer service also I want to override it. Okay, I'll close everything now. The base service, I defined one method called display name. The display name return type list, but inside that object term can be anything, either employee and customer. Okay, so that I given as a T. That is any class comes here. I am implemented this method in two classes, two service classes, which is base service. Whenever called customer service through the base service, it will return a customer object. Whenever called display by name from the employee service, this will return employee object. Okay. Okay. Now I want to use this service class inside a customer controller. Now I don't have to mention directly to the service name. I can mention just base service. Base service. Also, what happened? Yeah, base service dot display name. Employee controller. Here also base service. Yeah, we can keep it as an employee service also here, no worries. Okay, that is our issue. Okay, employee service is displaying. For better understanding, I keeping base service. You don't want to get any confusion. So, base service. So, slight modification I have done. I created a base service interface. Inside that, I define one method. That method return a list object. Okay, return the list object. This method implemented in customer service under employee service. While calling the customer service, the display by name return customer data. While calling employee service, this display name this display name by name return a employee data. Okay. Now here is a problem. Customer service controller also I'm using base service. Employee controller also I'm using base service. When you start this application, let's see what's happening. See, I got an error. The server is not started perfectly. Not started. Application failed to start. Field base service in com.itguard.res controller, customer controller required a single bin, but two were found. So this find the error is saying the same name, right? We are giving a base service in two places. Customer service also we have declared, employee service also we have declared. We are auto wired in two places. So our Spring framework are confused. It don't know what reference we need to keep. This base service implemented in two places. Customer service as well as employee service. But Spring framework don't know which class object should assign here. Which class object should assign? That the reason is giving like this error. Okay. To resolve this error, this kind of error, we need to go with at qualifier annotation. When you use this base service in the employee controller, I can use at qualifier annotation. Then I need to say employee service. When use the base service in customer controller, we need to use we can use the qualifier by using customer service. Now your Spring framework know that whenever start the application, what will happen? The Spring framework find this customer service object from the IOC container and assign that reference to the base service. Like this. Like employee controller also, whenever start the application, your Spring framework find this employee service object and assign to this interface type. Okay, through this we can avoid this error. So qualifier using if you are going to using multiple bin in a single interface type, that time we'll get some ambiguity problem. So to avoid that problem, we need to use qualifier annotation. Through qualifier annotation, we can tell that use this class type in this interface. Okay. We restart the start the server now. Successfully started now. So now Spring frameworks don't have any confusion. Okay, this guy mentioned employee service using qualifier annotation. So I want to assign employee service to this interface type. So here I mentioned qualifier followed by customer service. So your Spring framework know that it assigned customer service object to reference object to the base service annotation. Now I'll go to execute this. I want to display customer data. Customer name K7. Customer data is not a K7. Customer data is a, you go and check handler. Where is handler? Customer data is this one. I need to change comment there. Okay, customer data, this should, okay. I'm getting the customer information. Now I want to see the employee information. Employee Suresh, I got the employee information. This is the use of add qualifier. Okay, now we're going to talk about primary, add primary annotation. There is another way to tackle this kind of application, this kind of error, using primary. Now I'm going to remove this qualifier. Now I'll copy this project. I'm going to commit all. Actually, I'm going to committing all the examples in GitHub repository. Okay, you can take this project there. I'll share that link in the description section. You can pull it. Okay. Now I don't want to change this code, so I'll copy this. Keep it here. I'll copy this same qualifier. Okay, I copied that, so I remove this qualifier here from here. Remove this qualifier. Also in the employee controller also I am removing the qualifier. Now in the customer service class I want to if you start this application again you will get the error, right? Again you will get the error. Okay, so what I want to do is, by default I want to assign one class type in this interface. By default, I don't want to use qualifier, but by default, whenever start the application, assign this object reference to your interface type. I want to say to the Spring framework. How to do that? Through at Spring, primary annotation, you can do that. I want to by default assign customer service reference, customer service class reference to the interface. For that, you can tell here at primary. If you say at primary, what will happen? Your Spring framework by default take this customer service reference option to the base service interface. Now I'll going to start the application. Now it's started. By default customer, right? Let's see employee is coming or not. Employee is not coming. No. Customer. Customer data is printing now. Okay. Here Suresh, when it's pass Suresh here, it won't come because it's not able to assign the employee reference. Employee reference class not able to assign because we are not mentioning like that. Okay. But here employee service in the employee controller, we mentioned only base service. Still Spring don't know which service class we need to assign to this interface type. But by default it has a customer service, so it doesn't have any data. Here we need to use a qualifier. Now I'll go into restart. Okay, now I'll go into refresh it. Suresh data is coming, the employee data is coming. Okay, so using at primary we can give a default reference type to the interface class. Okay, this is the purpose of add primary annotation. Okay, if you have any question, please comment your questions in the description in the comment section. Definitely I will give you the answer. Next, in the next video, we're going to talk about how to create a web application, how to create a web application, and how, what is the constructor injection, what is the method injection. These things we're going to talk about upcoming videos. Please share this video to your friends and colleagues. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe this channel. Okay, until then, bye bye from Srishikesh.